Sometimes you get down when you make mistakes, when you lose hope, when you lose yourself, when you forget who you are. Darkness is around you, remorse bothers you.
Do you already know what you're gonna dress up for Nightmare Night?
I'll dress up as a vampire. Rarity made a witch costume for me.
Hello there!
You!
What do you want from us, Discord?
I wanted to visit Fluttershy, but she isn't at home, and in several other places. Maybe you know where she is?
We didn't see her today. We can't help you. Besides, I wonder why, after all you've done, she still keeps in touch with you.
Exactly!
You are still mad at me for that action with Tyrik, Chrysalis, and Cozy Glow, aren't you?
Yes, we are!
That was sick. You should be turned into stone with them. Let's go, girls. Freak.
Stupid kids. What are you staring at?
I think I bought everything I needed.
Hi, Fluttershy! It's just me. I didn't mean to scare you.
Please don't do that again.
Why are you so scared? Did someone do something to you?
No, just... today is Nightmare Night.
That's all? I thought you weren't afraid of this holiday anymore.
I wasn't. Until... last year. Sweetie Belle, Scootaloo, and Applebloom helped their friend with spell practice. However, something went wrong. And by accident, a spell was cast on a clown doll, which came to life and grew to the size of a house.
I wish I had seen it.
If it wasn't for Starlight, I don't know what would have happened. Since then, all the fears connected with the Nightmare Night came back to me.
It's okay now. If it makes you feel better, I will stay here overnight and make sure that nothing threatens you.
I don't want to cause you a problem.
Are you kidding? This isn't a problem for me.
I still don't understand what others see in these costumes.
You know, pretending to be someone else is fun. But, never mind. Try to sleep.
Okay.
What's wrong with me?
I had to leave earlier for the animal shelter. One of the animals is seriously ill. It looks like I'm going to be very busy this week. And I have to cancel our meeting. I hope you aren't mad at me, Fluttershy.
Sure. This is the third time this month. And again, I find out about it through a letter.
We didn't see her today. We can't help you. Besides, I wonder why, after all you've done, she still keeps in touch with you.
Maybe she avoids me? Maybe she is mad at me for certain events. She is too nice to say to my face that this is the end of our friendship. So she prefers to avoid me, just like other ponies.
Well, now that you've calmed down and stopped attacking us, let me tell you about my plan. Aren't you fed up with how ponies treat you? They run away from you, attack you, call you monsters, and you only fight for survival.
What would you say for a little revenge? Thanks to this medallion, it will be child's play. Let's show the ponies and everyone who stands in our way that we aren't brainless monsters. Let's show them what their place is.
It's nice that you came to us, Spike. It was fun talking to you.
I see that I came by at the right time. It's been a long time since we were all here together. How about a small round of ogres and oubliettes?
Sorry, Discord, but I don't have time. I have to go back to Twilight soon. I only came here for a moment.
And we're busy preparing.
Preparations? For what?
Me and Big Mac are expecting a baby.
So you will have dirty nappy sleepless nights and no time for anything. But other than that, that's really something to congratulate.
I knew as such an egoist like you wouldn't understand it. There's more to life than just having fun and caring for yourself.
I thought your wife was a lot nicer, Big Mac.
I just said the truth.
Discord!
What? Okay.
I know it can be hard for you to understand, but times are changing. And we all are too. Almost everybody.
Sure. Fluttershy first, now you. And nobody remembers about Discord. You always remember about me only when you need my powers.
Have you had an argument with Fluttershy?
No, but she has been making it clear to me for some time that she doesn't want to spend time with an old friend.
Can you finally tell her you fell in love with her?
Me? Lord of Chaos? And love?
Why not? Everyone gets it sooner or later. And that's probably why you're in a bad mood. That's why you want her company and try for her.
Me and Fluttershy are just friends. And it's normal for me to try for her. Like a friend for a friend.
As far as I know, Discord is immortal.
So what?
Even if he feels something for Fluttershy, he will outlive her. Such a relationship won't make sense because it will bring too much suffering to one of them.
Hey, listen. Fluttershy isn't my beloved. She is my friend, so you can stop talking about it.
Maybe it's better that you don't love her, because it could really hurt if she died.
Thank you for this pleasant conversation. Love? What love for the sake of Scorpan? I have experienced love once, and nothing good came out of it. It was an illusion and a pain. But Fluttershy is different than Cosmos. What's so cool about making lovey-dovey eyes, making dinners, and planning a life together? Ugh. What's wrong? Through my life with ponies, I became terribly soft. This is stupid. Spike talks nonsense. A sincere friendship is almost like love, but without love or something like this. I'll talk to Twilight. Who knows friendship better than the Princess of Friendship? She will definitely confirm that me and Fluttershy are just friends.
The school is going great! We have hired several new teachers.
I'm glad you're doing so well without me. I'll try to visit you soon.
It's awesome that everything is going so well.
Hi, Discord. What do you want?
Who, me? Do I always want something? I just wanted to visit an old friend. Oh, okay, you have seen me through, Your Highness. Some purple dragon thinks I'm in love with Fluttershy, which isn't true. I want you to confirm it. After all, you're the princess of friendship, aren't you?
Are you asking me for love advice?
What? No! No love advice! I'm asking you to confirm that me and Fluttershy are just friends.
Well, if your relationship with Fluttershy is as it was before, I can safely say that you're friends. This doesn't mean that friends cannot become something more. Practically, most relationships have such beginnings. Spike can read from others like a book, so...
Okay, stop. To be honest, I didn't expect it. Even if you are right, it still doesn't make sense. There is no point in loving someone who... You should know well what I'm talking about. Now you have a lot of friends, but they will age and die one day. You will outlive Applejack, Rarity, Rainbow Dash, Piggy Pie, and Fluttershy.
You're right. I never thought about it. I'm an alicorn, and they aren't.
Yeah, nice that you visited us, Discord, but I think it's time for you.
But... I just wanted to talk to Twilight!
And you talked! Congratulations, you've depressed her!
Starlight, wait! I didn't want to make Twilight sad. I feel confused for the first time in my life.
If I were you, I'd really think about how I feel. Listen to the voice of your heart. Remember that you won't run away from your feelings. Believe me, I know something about it. I got rid of him. Twilight, are you okay?
No, not completely. What will I do without my friends when they pass away?
I'm sure you can handle it, but this is a distant future. Don't worry about it now. And there's also Cadence, Flurryheart, and Discord. I don't help. Right.
Hey, Twilight. I came back. What happened?
Discord was here. He talked about immortality and other such.
I need to walk. Starlight, you can go home.
Are you sure?
Go back home. If something happens, I'll let you know.
What have I done to make them kick me out? These ponies are simply oversensitive. No matter what I do, there will always be something wrong. Am I really doing everything wrong? I have a feeling that everyone is just waiting for me to make another mistake. Even now, when I got to love this life, when I learned friendship. Maybe I really am doing everything wrong.
Welcome. I'm sorry to bother you, but...
Don't apologize for that, Twilight. What happened, my dear?
How did you deal with immortality? How did you endure that all the ponies around you were aging and dying? Didn't you think about finding a... or creating an immortality spell? So that all your friends could stay with you?
I'm sorry, but not even the most powerful magic can beat death and time. Even if there was a spell capable of giving immortality to unicorns, pegasi, and earth ponies, it would break the balance. Some would be immortal, others would not. Mortals would begin to envy the immortals. There would be riots. If everyone were immortal, there would be no room for new generations. Equestria would be overcrowded and unable to feed everyone.
I understand.
I know it's difficult for you. It has never been easy for us. But some things cannot be changed. Not everyone can be alicorns. This is the price for power and immortality. Don't be afraid of the future, Twilight. Also enjoy what is now.
I'll try.
Podyfield looks so calm today. As usual. For several months. Why should I care that some pony won't die? No, what am I talking about? I shouldn't say that. Not about Fluttershy. Listen to the voice of the heart. This is stupid. It's just a blood-pumping organ. Okay, so be it. I have nothing to lose. What am I feeling? It is really...
What are you doing here?
I just admired how beautiful Ponyville looks today. Nice to see you, Fluttershy.
Nice to see you too.
Can you put me down? We just left the spa! You have no idea how much effort it takes to keep your mane in perfect condition!
Relax, Rarity. It's only hair.
Only hair? Only hair?! Why are you defending him again, Fluttershy? Did you forget what he did? He put our land in danger several times!
But I helped fix it!
Don't be funny!
Please don't argue.
We fought to defend Equestria. We cleaned the mess you made!
Rarity!
I'm surprised that after all he has done, you're still so friendly with him. Even forgiveness has its limits. Let's see, you took control over Equestria twice. When the princess disappeared, you didn't bother to tell us about the evil seeds. Then you joined T-Rex. I won't mention your last action. We all know what I'm talking about.
I have changed. You're wrong.
Your behavior doesn't indicate this. It just shows that you still have no idea about friendship. And you will never change. Because there is still darkness in you.
I wasn't the one who was spreading rumors around Ponyville.
What? Does it bother you that everyone knows what you did?
Please, stop it.
Ponies treat me even worse than when I rode Equestria.
Hey,
you get what you deserve, you
they
beast.
They are arguing again.
Can't you see? Discord!
What? She got what she deserved? I don't understand how you can be friends with such a drama queen like Rarity.
Such creatures like you will never change. You will always be a monster.
Say that again.
Stop it right now. You act worse than children. I'm fed up with all your quarrels. Until you make up, I don't want anything to do with you.
But Fluttershy...
Don't talk to me.
Sugar Cube. See what you led to. Are you proud of yourself?
Okay, I'll apologize to her and promise I won't argue with Rarity anymore, even if this meanie provokes me. And maybe I'll tell her about my feelings, about what I suspect I feel. I should be honest with her. Listen, Fluttershy, there is one more thing I would like to tell you. I feel I should tell you that. The point is that, I guess...
Why
is talking about feelings so difficult? Huh?
What? Who is this guy? Fluttershy has someone, and I don't know about it. Her best friend? Good morning!
Good morning.
If you have nothing to tell me about yesterday's behavior, we have nothing to talk about, Discord.
Yeah, about that. I'm sorry.
You know perfectly well that you shouldn't only apologize to me.
Yes, I know. I promise I won't argue with Rarity anymore.
And?
And I'll apologize to her. If we get along, maybe you can introduce me to this gentleman.
Meet Nightlight. Do you like the ring he chose for the proposal?
Proposal?
He's going to propose to his girlfriend.
Phew. So he didn't want to give it to Fluttershy.
Everything's so great. First Big Mac and Sugar Bell are expecting a baby. Now Nightlight and his girlfriend will be engaged. It's amazing how love can change someone's life. It's a great feeling to have with someone whom you want to spend the rest of your days.
It's true.
Discord? Are you okay?
Sure. I'm happy. For others.
Then why do you look bleak?
You know, I've just remembered I had to do something important today. Very important, and I can't wait. See ya!
Oh. Bye.
What am I doing? Ah! I'll wait for this guy to leave and then try to talk to her. But what if she doesn't feel the same? I'll only make a fool of myself.
Fluttershy, wasn't it the monster who unified T-Rex, Chrysalis, and Cozy Glow and pretended to be Grogar himself?
Monster?
Discord isn't a monster!
Hey! Watch how you fly!
Give me a break, Rainbow Dash! Why can't those stupid ponies forget about it? I made a mistake! Many mistakes! I apologized! I regret them! I helped with fixing them too! But no! Let's remind Discord about every bad deed! Every mistake he made! Let's forget about the good he did! No matter how much I try for them, I'll always be a monster! And they won't like this too, for sure!
Why are you doing this? I thought we were friends! Discord, how could you do this to Twilight?
I can't do that. I don't want to. I've hurt Fluttershy too many times. You don't even know how lucky you are to have someone like Fluttershy.
Wasn't it the monster who unified T-Rex, Chrysalis, and Cozy Glow and pretended to be Grogar himself?
Freak. Freak. You will never freak. Because there is still darkness in you. You get what you deserve, you beast.
You turn into stone with them.
You will always be a monster.
I'm not a monster. I'm not. Who am I kidding? I'll never be one of them. They will never fully accept or trust me. And Fluttershy, why would she love someone like me if she could easily find some handsome stallion? Nobody needs me. They'll never forget. So, time for me to step aside. Goodbye.
There was a time when I was grateful. There was a time. got the greatest gift, but now it's a curse for me. I feel emptiness, I feel hopeless, I'm afraid about the future. I don't want to live without them, I don't wanna be
They call me a monster, they call me a freak and beast, but they forgot that I also have a heart. There is one thing which hurts me more than their words. Someone I love someday will disappear and gone. I don't want to live without her. I don't wanna be alone again.
Others want immortality, happiness, and long life. They forgot that everything has a cost. Where is the sense of eternity when there's nobody to share it with? I never asked for this gift. Someday I'll return to the point where I began.
I'll be alone again.
Alone
again.
Maybe we misheard it.
It's better to check it anyway. We cannot allow any intruder to disrupt our plans.
Who? What is it?
Shut up!
Oh, I know! This is Discord, the spirit of chaos and disharmony. He has powerful magic he currently uses for good, and he can be a serious threat to us.
This Discord?
Yes.
What shall we do with him?
We have to get rid of him somehow, by deceit.
He is a magical being. I can block his magic with my venom. Without his magic, he'll be defenseless. And then my lethal venom will kill him, too.
From what I can see, he is sleeping. What kind of fool is taking a nap in the middle of every forest?
He looks exhausted to me.
The better for us. It won't be difficult to sneak up on him.
As soon as he wakes up, we run into the bushes.
Ouch! Who? What? Who bit me? A snake or what? Me and my luck.
I think everything is ready for today's tea with Discord. We haven't spent much time together lately. He should be here any minute. Ah.
It's morning already? And Discord didn't appear at all yesterday. He never missed our tea parties. But why? Did something come up? Then why didn't he send a letter? Or maybe he thinks that this week our meeting is also canceled? Thinking about it now, last time I saw him was a week ago. He gave no sign of life at all during this time. What if something happened to him? Maybe he's sick? I'll visit him and check if he's okay.
You know, Spike, I decided to visit Ponyville tomorrow.
Does it have to do with what Discord told you?
Maybe a little bit. But I just want to see the girls. Recently, I feel a strange anxiety, as if something bad has happened. I need to check if Ponyville and my friends are safe.
What about Canterlot?
It's so peaceful here. Advisors will do without me for a day or two. Celestia and Luna have also left Canterlot many times.
What? What is that sound? Cry? Must be we're around. Maybe someone is hurt or needs help or something. I must know what's going on. I'm coming. Lonely Draconiquis. Here? A joker before, now in tears. Hey, what happened? Why are you alone? And so far from friends and home. What worries are bothering your mind? Tell me, please. You don't need to hide.
What worries? Can't you see that smile on my face? I'm fine.
Then why I see tears in your eyes?
Tears? What tears? Look, Manticore!
Wait, I feel something is very wrong. You shouldn't be alone. You can't do it for long. What's wrong with him? The forest becomes even more grim. First, these strange prints that I found recently. Now the animals are terrified. They run away hurriedly. Something is circling amongst the trees. This creature is evil. I feel it is. I have to go to Ponyville and tell Princess everything I know about the threat, about Discord. We must find out what's going on. And Fluttershy, she must worry about her friend. Here, being in such a condition, he isn't safe.
It's good to be back.
Twilight! It's you! It's you!
I'm also glad to see you, Pinkie Pie.
What are you doing here, Twilight?
Sweet Equestria, what a surprise!
Oh, I missed Ponyville and decided to look here.
Girls, it's good that you're here.
Hi, Fluttershy. Did something happen?
No, I mean, I think so, but I hope not.
You look nervous, darling.
Go ahead. If something bothers you, you know that you can tell us, Sugar Cube.
Did someone eat your cake that you were saving for later? Does your stomach hurt?
Maybe let her speak, Pinky.
Oh, okie dokie.
Oh. Okay. It's about Discord.
About him? What did he do this time?
He did nothing. He didn't write back to my letter. He didn't show up at the tea party yesterday. I haven't seen him all week. He isn't at his home either. I have searched his whole dimension. I'm worried about him. I'm afraid something bad has happened to him and I don't even know where he is.
Hello there. Ponies, my friends.
Zecora.
Oh, Princess. What's with that troubled face?
Fluttershy says Discord has disappeared somewhere. When I last saw him, I had the impression that something was wrong with him.
Because it is! There's always something wrong with him! This is Discord! Hello!
I saw him in Everfree Forest, where he laid to rest. He looked tired and shattered, so I came over and asked what happened.
And what happened next?
When he saw me, he suddenly stood up, and I could see terrible pain in his eyes. I was very worried about this and wanted to give a hoof, but he smiled fake and stated that I did not need to. Then he quickly left before I could do anything. I ran after him, but when saw it, he disappeared.
Oh no.
It's weird. Even for him.
Maybe we should give him some time?
He did not look good, and that makes me afraid. Discord is a powerful being, my friends. But now something with him is wrong, and in the Everfree Forest, weakened creatures will not last long.
We need to find him!
You'd probably find him in the wood. But to be honest, don't go there for your own good.
What do you mean?
Forest animals warned against a dangerous beast. It is hidden in the shades of trees, does not spare anyone will see, and attacks violently, without mercy.
Twilight, please! Let's search the forest. He's our friend. We can't leave him alone.
If you want to go, stick together, even when you go astray. The strength of your friendship will always find a way.
What in the heck are they doing here?
Stick together! We'll chase them out where they came from!
Run!
Trixie! Pinky, are you alright?
Have you tried to learn to fly?
For what sins?
No.
I hope you have a good explanation.
Let's just say uninvited guests have come to Ponyville.
Timberwolves apocalypse!
This isn't the time for panic, Trixie. We must help them!
Twilight! I know what to do to get rid of them!
What neutralized?
We can send them back to where they came from. We can teleport them.
Together we can do it.
Okay, let's do this.
Go, go, go! You can do it!
Yahoo!
Can anyone tell me what that was supposed to be?
It seems they were bored.
But why did they do it?
Wait, Timberwolves came from the Everfree Forest.
Me don't say.
And for several days, as far as I know, Discord has also been there. Assuming purely hypothetically, what if he sent those creatures on us?
This makes sense.
Really?
What? Rainbow Dash Rarity? You aren't serious. Discord wouldn't do that.
I would argue with this, Fluttershy. I'm just trying to connect the dots.
Did you even listen to what Sakura said? He's probably depressed, and the last thing he would think about in such a situation is sending Timberwolves on Ponyville. Why would he do that? Why can't you finally forgive him? Since the events with Chrysalis and the others, some of you are constantly reminding him of his mistakes. The truth is, you aren't much better. Did you forget how Rarity went crazy decorating everything? Or how Rainbow Dash pretended to like Pinky's cakes? Or how Pinky cloned herself in a magical lake?
Calm down, Fluttershy! I didn't mean to upset you!
I know where you're going with that. But no offense, darling. We've never put our whole country in danger.
No, I'm not going to calm down. Since this morning, I've been as stressed as never before. You don't know what it's like when your friends see only evil in the one you love!
You fell in love with Discord?
What a coincidence.
I knew it. Somehow I'm not surprised.
Yay! That's awesome!
But how? How such a good and nice pony like you fall in love with someone like Discord?
Rarity!
Our friendship became stronger over time. Or at least what I felt. I feel... When I thought Discord was seriously hurt by Sombra.
I think it's very romantic. It reminds me of a story I once heard. The title was... Well, there was something about a beast. Hey, where are you going?
I'm going to find Discord. If I find him, I'll find out if he really sent Timberwolves on us.
Hey, hold your horses, Fluttershy. What? What I'm saying?
We didn't say we wouldn't help you.
That's right.
Sakura, will you help us?
Okay. Let's search the woods until it's bright. We must find Discord before it becomes night.
Starlight, Sunburst, Trixie, take care of Ponyville during our absence. Prepare yourself to repel Timberwolves' attacks if they appear. Take this, too.
Twilight, you can't. Celestia and Luna gave it to you.
You...
In the forest, I won't be able to ensure that the sun sets. If something happens to us and we don't return...
Don't talk nonsense. You've dealt with a lot worse other than a bunch of oversized sticks.
I know. But it will be safer with you. The three of you should be able to raise the moon to the sky.
Can I touch it?
Are you ready?
Ready!
Hi. What happened to you?
A minor accident while working in the shelter. I wanted to clean up one of the cages, and when I was carrying a bucket, I spilled water and slipped.
Does it hurt a lot?
A little bit. What are you doing? Ouch.
You'll see, my dear. Better?
Yes, you healed me. Oh, thank you. You're such a sweetheart.
Anything for my favorite pony and best close friend forever.
Friend. Discord isn't evil anymore. I won't believe that he sent timberwolves on us. He wouldn't hurt me.
Fluttershy, is everything okay?
No!
Maybe we should tell her.
About what?
You know, that Discord may have a crush on her?
No, Spike. Fluttershy and Discord must explain it to each other by themselves.
Don't cry, little one. You'll see. We'll find him fast.
I'd like to find him. Hug him. Comfort him. Some ponies think that after what he did, I shouldn't hang out with him. It's true that I was angry with him, but I forgave him. Again. I saw that he was very sorry and tried very hard to make it up to me. Just like when he betrayed us to join T-Rex. We had a very long and honest conversation back then. He told me that he'd joined T-Rex because he thought we were pretending to be his friends, just so that he wouldn't become evil again. He would feel lonely. In fact, his life was very sad. He never had friends before. Ponies rejected him because of his otherness. After that conversation, I promised myself that I would always support him. I would do everything in my power to show him that he wasn't alone anymore.
A friend like you is a treasure. You know, I think he's feeling a lot of pressure. Because everything he did, they leave an imprint on him. It is not easy to leave it all behind us. And yet, you give him care, support, and trust. He is very lucky to have someone like you. Don't worry about others' opinions and their truth. Everyone makes mistakes. We have no obligation to forgive. But others should not count. If your heart condone him.
Discord, where are you?
Panky, we should be careful. We don't know what's going on here, except that it's nothing good.
So, how else do you want to find Discord?
We'll go to the place where Zecora saw him last time. Maybe we'll find some tips there. If not, we'll try to search at least part of the forest.
Since Discord is here and he's escaped from Zecora, it means that he doesn't want company, so that scream will only frighten him away.
Help me!
I've got you, Pinkie.
Pinkie Pie! Applejack!
A Rainbow Dash, wait!
Twilight! What are you doing? Let me go! We have to help them!
What if it's a trap? We'll get into hot water. We must be careful.
Applejack? Pinkie Pie? Are you here?
What if something ate them and we'll never see them again?
So Discord suddenly became a pony eater now?
There are no signs of a fight. Or blood anywhere.
What is this stench?
Is some pony here?
Rarity! Fluttershy! Run!
What about Twilight and Zecora?
Run! We'll find you later!
Princess!
And who did you bring here? What are those ponies.
What? They entered the forest? Are they looking for Discord?
Pinkie Pie, are you okay?
Yes, I'm pretending to be unconscious, and I suggest that you do the same.
They drove the two of you out of your pack. A group of weak ponies beat you down.
It's a chimera.
Quiet, quiet, quiet. I managed to overhear a little. It seems that the chimera and the Timberwolves want to take their revenge on ponies. I don't know what for, and I decided to start with Ponyville. It looks like the chimera is their boss.
Find them and kill them. No mercy.
We'll be going now. Bye!
Catch them and kill them! We will join the others. By the way, we'll check if that Draconicus is dead yet. My venom should have killed him long ago.
Where am I? What happened?
Twilight, you have finally woken up. Do you have a headache or something like that? During the fight, you were hit really hard on the head. For a moment, I was afraid you were dead. But I saved you and defeated them I managed. The whole Timberwolves pack. Can you imagine? What a ride. And you slept like a little filly. You have to admit, it was kind of silly.
Thanks, Akora. Girls! Spike, we must find them as soon as possible! Have we been eaten by a Dydra? Maybe I can teleport us out of here. What? No, I can't use my magic! Oh, my friends are in danger, and we're stuck in the stomach of a stupid Hydra! If I die here, Celestia and Luna are gonna kill me!
I didn't expect to get stuck a Hydra's inside. Interesting experience, but we have to get outside. A blessing in disguise. I have some herbs with me. Thanks to them, we'll get out of here. Mixing them properly will free us, but it will take a moment to Hydra buck up.
I'm not feeling well. My claw is getting numb. Maybe I should go back to Ponyville.
Rarity!
Discord? I never thought I'd be so happy to see you!
Don't touch my face! The only pony allowed to do it is Fluttershy! Fluttershy! Why isn't my magic working? I'm coming! I'll catch you! I'll catch you!
Did something hurt you? Are you okay? Speak to me!
Dizzy! It's so good to see you! I was so worried.
Flutter, you're joking me. What were you thinking coming to the Everfree Forest?
We were looking for you, you idiot.
Me?
Yes, silly. What were you thinking coming to the Everfree Forest? A week? A whole week here? Without a word? You thought nobody would be worried about you? Especially Fluttershy! I'll kill you! I'll kill you!
Rainbow Dash, calm down!
Spike, let me go!
Timberwolves! 1, 2, 4! 4 Timberwolves!
They've been chasing us practically since we entered the forest. We split up, though. I thought we lost them.
Discord, could you take care of them?
This time we really need your magic!
There is a small, tiny problem. I lost my magic. Again.
What?
Seriously? What time is this now? The 5th?
I don't know. After the second time, I lost count.
Great.
Maybe we can just get out of the forest.
We can't leave Twilight, Sakura, AJ, and Pinky here.
They're here too? Where?
We don't know. We lost them.
Dead end.
Can't beat four Timberwolves.
Do you want to fight? Come here! I'll turn you into termite food!
Rainbow Dash, find the others.
I won't leave you!
Excellent! You caught several intruders. This hide-and-seek game has already begun to bore us.
Chimera! Why aren't you in the fire swamps?
Seriously? Are you interested in that right now, little dragon?
Why do you want to hurt us? We didn't do anything to you.
I would argue with that. We had to leave the fire swamps if we didn't want to starve. The Everfree Forest remained our only hope.
On the way, we found a medallion in one of the old caves. When we put it on, it turned out we can wield magic.
Since we had such an opportunity, we couldn't miss it. A great time to get revenge on ponies.
But for what? Why? If someone hurt you, you could always talk about it.
Talk? Talk?
Everfree Forest existed long before Ponyville was created.
And the creatures that inhabited it, and the areas outside of it.
Where your town is now, the Everfree Forest used to grow proudly.
Until Celestia arrived and gave these lands to ponies. Our ancestors and other creatures were banished deep into the woods, into fire swamps and such.
Some of the creatures were trapped in the Taurus. Some were killed. But the memory of these events has never been lost. The ponies' behavior towards everything other than them still remains the same.
You ponies only care about your own species. You don't care about other creatures. You treat them like something worse.
That's not true.
Now Equestria is open to all kinds of creatures.
Sure. The question is, how long will it last? Your race has no tolerance of otherness in its genes.
Unless it's in your favor. Right, Discord?
The whole of Equestria has heard your fate. How many times has your wonderful chaos been condemned by ponies? How many times have they moved away from you? How many times have they called you a monster?
Discord, don't listen to her.
You've lost all your dignity. You've become a puppet of ponies. And they still don't respect you. And this will never change.
You only accept other creatures only if they meet your conditions. And every non-pony who dares to be different is punished. How fair. Why did the Lord of Chaos spend so much time alone in the forest if he could spend it with you? Maybe because he was fed up with how you treat him?
Discord, is that true? Why didn't you tell me?
What would you do? Would you make the ponies treat me differently?
How did you know that Discord was in the woods for a week?
We heard it scream. We found him when he was sleeping soundly. An intruder like him was a threat to our plan.
Yes, the bite on your claw is my doing. My venom has finally blocked your magic, and now it's slowly weakening you until it finally kills you. I'm surprised that it took so long. It seems your chaos magic is so powerful that it slowed down and blocked the venom, but eventually gave up.
Although, we are willing to give you the chance to avoid painful death. If you join us, I know how to reverse the effects of my venom.
What have you gotten from obeying the ponies? You can't be your real self because they don't accept your true nature.
Don't do this, please. We'll find another way to save you.
Do you really think I could betray you again?
So?
No, I won't join you. Even if I did, you would certainly use me in a similar way Tyrek once did. Revenge won't solve anything, and certainly won't bring relief. It may not be too easy for me at the moment, but I also have something very precious, and I don't want to lose it.
You're not talking about this pathetic little yellow jelly.
Don't talk about her like that. She has more brains in her head than your three heads put together. And as long as my heart beats in my chest, I won't let anyone hurt her or her friends. You will pay for this!
Timberwolves! Attack them!
We need to help them!
I'm with you, Rainbow Dash.
Isn't a good time to faint?
Take that!
It's a shame you didn't come out with that fire before, Spike! Hey! What's going on?
Dizzy! Spikey Wikey!
No!
There's a lot of blood! This is my blood!
Holy Celestia, your wing!
No! Run!
What about Fluttershy and Discord?
When we get rid of the Timberwolves, we'll find them!
Were it not for this avalanche, we would have them! But we won't give up so easily!
We're safe here. At least I hope so.
Fluttershy, we should find the others as soon as possible.
Do you think I don't know that? But I don't want you to bleed out on the way. The moss has healing properties and will stop bleeding. You saved my life. Thank you.
You're welcome. Without my magic, I'm more vulnerable than usual. What's that for?
For nothing. I feel like you need warmth and closeness now. I've never seen you so sad before. Tell me what's wrong.
Later. Since you've finished these skincare treatments, let's go to the others.
I'm just worried about you. Chimera venom circulates in your veins and slowly kills you. What if we fail? I don't want you to die.
I'll be alright. The sooner we join Twilight and the rest, the sooner we can find a way to neutralize the Chimera and the Venom.
Okay. You always know how to comfort me. Oh no! It's Timberwolves!
They must have smelled my blood.
No! Luna, what's going on? We must go to Ponyville. Twilight needs us.
Fluttershy.
Watch out.
Another Timberwolf. No, I can't give up now.
Okay.
Celebrate, Pinky. Let's go.
Okay. Team Apple Pie to the rescue.
Hadra!
Was it just me, or did I hear Applejack and Pinky? Is it you girls? Oh, we're free! Finally!
Discord! I got you!
Fluttershy, what are you doing? You can't hold me for too long! Save yourself!
No, I won't let you fall!
Fluttershy? Oh no, no, no! It's all my fault! You're alive!
Did you think I died? You should have checked my breathing and pulse.
Whoops.
And there's also something called first aid.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
If I were as strong and fast as Rainbow Dash, I could have saved both of us. Instead, I'm a small and weak Pegasus. I'm so worried about the others. I asked them to come with me and look for you, but I just put us all in danger.
Don't say that, my dear. You couldn't have known the Chimera was here. I didn't notice that something was happening, and I've been here for a week. Chimera clearly planned it all, and you may not have great physical strength, but you are strong in spirit. You have a big heart and courage. Your kindness, empathy, gentleness, those are your strength. Thanks to you, I'm who I am today, and I am grateful for that.
I just want this nightmare to end.
I know. We'll get out of this. Everybody. You'll see. We have to be strong for our friends. It's really my fault. Again. If I didn't escape to the forest, you and the others wouldn't have come here to look for me. If I still had my magic, I could have taken that strange medallion in no time and dealt with the Timberwolves. It's me. Without the magic of chaos, I'm weak and useless. I'm nobody.
That's not true. You're a great friend, with or without magic. No one has ever defended me like you did today. Even if you hadn't disappeared in the woods, we all would have gone to see what was going on. Because the Timberwolves attacked Ponyville.
This day is too chaotic, even for me. I think we should move away and try to find Twilight and the rest of the team again.
I know, but before we move on, there's something you need to know. I fell in love with you.
No. What am I doing? I'm giving her hope. You shouldn't have done that. We shouldn't. We can't.
But why?
It doesn't make sense. We won't find them like this. The Everfree Forest is too big. And recently I've learned of a spell that can help. But if I cast it, there's a great risk that the Timberwolves will see it too. Oh. On the other hand, I don't see any other option. This spell will bring the girls, Spike, and Discord straight to us. We have to hide somewhere here and wait. I hope I did the right thing.
What do you mean we shouldn't?
Fluttershy, you know perfectly well that this isn't a good time for such a conversation. We'll talk about feelings later.
Discord, are you okay?
It's the venom. I'm running out of time.
Twilight!
How could you have come up with such an idea? Did you want to kill me or what? At least they came up with an idea that worked, and thanks to it, we got rid of that bunch of running sticks. Though making me bait so Spike could set them afire was very clever, it almost ate me up!
Can you stop it? We have other problems on our mind right now.
You want to play hide and seek with us again? You know you can't win.
I have no idea what to do. If we run straight to Twilight, we'll lead the Chimera to her too. There won't be time to come up with a plan to take off the medallion.
From what I noticed, that medallion has very powerful magic in it. I think its magic is even more powerful than Twilight's magic.
Ready for the second round! And this time, the last...
Fluttershy! Run! Warn the others! I'll stop the Chimera as long as I can!
I'll come back for you. I promise.
Are you sure it's Twilight?
Rainbow Dash, Rarity, Spike, you're okay!
Where have you been?
Let's not talk about things that spoil mood. For your own good.
That's you! I'm so happy! Great idea with that spell, Twilight!
You'll never believe what we found out. Let me guess. The Chimera united the Timberwolves, became their leader, has a medallion that gives magical powers to anyone who wears it, they poisoned Discord with venom and it's killing him now?
How do you know that?
Let's just say we met Chimera too.
Chimera? Timberwolves? A magic medallion of venom that's killing Discord?
Girls!
Fluttershy!
Discord's fighting Chimera. He told me to run away and find you. I'll tell you everything on the way. We have to get him before it's too late.
This medallion... I've read about it. It's one of Rogar's creations that was declared missing. Rogar evoked a creature too powerful to control even for him. He didn't manage to destroy it, but he did succeed in weakening and trapping it in the medallion. This medallion gives magical powers to anyone who wears it, but there's a catch. The longer someone wears it and uses it, the more the soul of the carrier is absorbed. If the monster absorbs the whole soul of the Chimera, it'll gain enough strength to free itself.
Are you saying this medallion is one big ticking monster? Do something! He'll strangle me!
I move it? Gorg! I'm fed up with this fair fight! Are you still alive?
Let me put an end to your suffering.
What's happening?
The end of your fun! This is for my tail!
You're safe now. We're here. Please don't die.
I'm still alive. You should have checked the breathing and the pulse.
Oh, I thought I came too late.
You came just in time, I guess.
Is this another chimera bite?
I can't take this cursed medallion off!
Me neither.
What was that?
Do you really think that we would give it to you that easily?
Enough! You and your Timberwolves hurt me and my friends. You almost killed us. What's more, you put all of Equestria and yourself in great danger. The medallion you wear is cursed. A powerful beast called Ekrios is trapped in it, born of old and very powerful dark magic. If you don't take off the medallion, Ekrios may break free, consume your souls and body, and do the same with all the other creatures. This will be the end of our world!
How can we be sure that you aren't lying?
I never lie in such important matters as the safety of my kingdom, friends, and subjects. I know it's hard to forget about the wrongs and mistakes of the past, but there are other ways to find relief and compensation than through revenge. My friends have taught me that goodness, kindness, and empathy can change a lot in this world. They can drive darkness away from the heart of almost every being. And that's why I want to give you a chance. We don't have to fight. We don't have to be enemies. I know many who, with the help of new friends, overcame the darkness in themselves and found the light. Though, I also know those who stubbornly believed in their arguments, and their own interests chose darkness and rejected the chance for a different life. Any path you choose is only your choice. We can't change the past, but we still have an influence on the future and how it will be.
Your speech was sweet, but I'm afraid it didn't change our attitude.
Why haven't they returned yet? It's been 5 hours since they entered the forest.
Maybe they visited Zecora's hut?
Really?
Starlight, where is Twilight?
I thought you were retired.
We are, but I had a vision. All of Equestria is in serious danger.
Serious danger?
What is this?
What's happening to us?
It hurts!
He is huge!
No,
disgusting!
Holy Celestia!
And to that one, I prefer a chimera. Did he eat him?
Didn't you see?
Girls, I think it's time to use the magic of friendship.
I hope this works.
It has to work. It always works.
Come on! We have to protect them! Leave them alone! Hey, Lulu!
That's the kind of plot twist I like!
Celestia? Luna? How did our magic lose against this thing? It seems that the evil hatred and desire to destroy within Ekrios are so powerful that he has overcome harmony! Come on! We have to help them! Together, we have a chance to defeat Ekrios!
Twilight, wait! Discord's getting worse and worse! He can't fight in this state!
I'm fine. I can help you.
But, Discord, for Celestia's sake, what are you doing?
I guess there's no one else to help because Celestia and Luna have just been knocked out by Ancreas' magic blast!
It's a pity there was no description of how Grover defeated and imprisoned him in any of the books!
How are we supposed to take the medallion out of it if it doesn't have any weak points?
Maybe. His eye is a weak spot. If we hurt it, maybe we would weaken it enough to pull the medallion out of his body.
Pinky, the magic of friendship nor the magic of alicorns did nothing to him. How could that work?
Do you have any other ideas?
We have to try to do it. Pinky may be right. Luna, Twilight, and I will try to hurt his eye.
And what do we have to do?
Don't get killed or caught by tentacles, and protect each other.
Seems reasonable.
Twilight, remove the barrier.
Guys, watch out for tentacles! Die!
I have to try and use magic. Chimera venom may have blocked it, but the magic of chaos is still inside me.
Help!
Let her go! I did it! I used magic!
Do these tentacles have a mind of their own?
What the? Using my magic made the venom work faster?
Discord, what was that? Do you feel worse?
Focus on the fight! Don't worry about me!
Now!
Did we destroy him?
I don't think so.
What just happened?
Wow, what a big hole!
Where is he?
It just got strangely quiet here.
No! What the hey?
Please, let us go!
What does he want to do with us?
He wants to drain life energy out of us. Just like he did with Chimera!
We are gonna die! Goodbye, world!
No, it can't end this way! Maybe I can destroy it with my magic, once and for all. But if I use magic, the venom would probably kill me. But if thanks to this, Fluttershy and the others will be safe. It's worth it. In the end, I'll do something really useful.
Come on! Work your stupid magic!
How is this possible?
But the venom blocked his magic!
Well, I think I know what made this occur. It's the feelings which he has for her. Priceless, hidden deep in the heart. Everyone would like to take part of each other power in the world that's far above, stronger than chaos, hatred, friendship, it's love.
This is so romantic.
Maybe we'll get a move on and fight this thing too? I haven't felt so useless for a long time.
Where did this fog come from?
I have a bad feeling.
Dizzy? You're just unconscious. You'll wake up soon, right?
Maybe I'm blind, but I can't see his side and chest moving.
No.
Discord, can you hear me? Say something. Please. Don't do this to me. Don't die. Open your eyes. Wake up! I can't hear his heartbeat!
Poor Discord.
I I wasn't with you when you needed me the most. This is all my fault. I didn't even notice there was something wrong with you. Please come back. You promised me. You promised that everything would be fine. You're my best friend. I need you. I love you with all my heart. You're my hero, and I'm proud of you.
I think his powerful magic of chaos kept him alive. But during the fight, he used his power to protect and help us thrive. He sacrificed himself, paying a huge cost. A noble jester, giving his life. Now, he is lost.
Fluttershy, I'm so sorry. Are you sorry? You and Rainbow Dash have never really liked Discord. You've always blamed him for everything. You have no right to mourn him.
Fluttershy, I never wished he died.
Me neither.
Leave me alone. Everyone, just leave me alone.
No, you shouldn't be alone now. Discord was also our friend. We are sorry, too.
You have no idea how I feel. Besides Applejack, you don't know what it's like to lose a loved one. I'll never look into his eyes again. I'll never hear his laughter again. He was always with me. He could always listen to me. Make me laugh and comfort me. I know he wasn't perfect. He made mistakes. But he wasn't bad. He cared about you. He cared about me. Discord, he doesn't deserve such a fate. He doesn't deserve to die. I would give everything I have if he could come back to me.
I can't even hear a single breath, but maybe we can still save him from death. There is a chance, a small ray of hope, but to try, we must move to my hut quickly and not pause to mope.
But how? Is it even possible? Is this not necromancy?
I have an old book. It lies on the shelf and is just collecting dust. But now, it is the only thing we can trust. It contains recipes for many a healing potion. One will be able to neutralize the poison and restore life stolen. If some of his magic of chaos survived, then perhaps he can be revived.
So what are we waiting for? Let's hurry up!
Okay. I'll teleport us to Sakura's hut.
Luna and I will stay here and look for the medallion. We will join you later.
It didn't take Celestia and Luna much time to find the medallion. Or rather, what was left of it. Discord destroyed the medallion, and with it, the monster that was connected to it by a curse. Equestria was safe once again.
Don't worry. Everything will be fine.
You really do love him.
I don't expect you to understand it. That's why I didn't tell anyone.
We aren't going to judge you.
For us, the most important thing is for you to be happy.
And if Discord gives you happiness, who are we to take it away from you?
The potion is prepared. Fluttershy, lift his head.
I still don't understand how the potion's supposed to bring him back to life.
The thing is, we don't know for sure about it. Our knowledge isn't very broad. You see, Chimera Venom has its properties that are odd. Its last stage is putting the victim into a death-like state. If he's there, the potion will save him. If we're not too late. All we can do is look after him. Wait and pray. There is no other way. Now, I shall take care of Discord and watch over him. You should go to Ponyville and rest before the light grows too dim.
I'll stay here. I want to be with him when he wakes up.
Well, if you want to stay so bad, stay the night. I think your presence will help him fight.
See you tomorrow!
Take care, Fluttershy.
Bye.
Here, drink these herbs. They will give you a peaceful rest without perturbs. They pacify your thoughts and numb how you feel. Peace of mind and sleep will help you heal.
Will that really help him?
If it works, he'll come back to life. Do not cry. Be brave. Hope is the last thing to die.
So blind as to not see your pain, but now I know you were hurting. You threw your life away. How could any pony not see the beauty in yourself? If I had known how empty you felt, you wouldn't be. But now I'm here and you're still, and this day did not go as planned. But I will stay here and wait for you. Then the sunrise can begin again. I would do anything, almost anything, to see your smile sun, but the sunrise hasn't begun. If only the sign were clear, your chest would not be so hollow. Now my head is aching from this unforgiven sorrow. Could it be that I was too late? This guilt was weighed on my chest. The best I can do for you is sit here instead. But I will stay here and wait for you. Then the sunrise can be. Do anything, almost anything, to see your smile in the sun. But the sunrise hasn't begun. But I will stay here and wait in the rain, night and day. A sign of hope and purity, but I had to watch you sleeping. But I will stay here and wait for you, then the sunrise can begin again.
And so, waiting for Zecor's actions to work or fail, the day has passed. Fluttershy's friends visited Zecora's hut for a while to see how their Pegasus friend was doing.
Zecora, it's been a day since you gave him that antidote, and still nothing. No breath. No heartbeat.
Please do not cry or give sorrowful chime. There's still a bit of hope. Just give him time.
No, he won't wake up anymore, right? This time, even your abilities have failed. Discord? I'm so sorry. Discord? Why did you have to leave me? It's unfair.
Hi, Fluttershy!
Why didn't he wake up? Your potion worked, right?
I was hoping that my knowledge would somehow help, as always. But he, even doctors would find a haze. Healing magic damage, they barely know about it. I tried my best, but failure is all I have left.
No, it can't be.
Is he really gone?
Not every story has a happy ending, and we learned it in the hardest way. It's a pity that we appreciated Discord when it was too late, when he was gone. All we could do was to thank him, say we were sorry, and hope that wherever his soul was, he could hear us. It's sad how far hatred and anger can go, and lead to disasters that can't be taken back. We should remember that when we are mad at someone, it does not only affect that person, but also the ones who still care about them. The day before the funeral, Fluttershy begged me to go back in time.
Twilight, please! I beg you! We can find another way to destroy Akrios! Go back in time and stop Discord from defeating him!
But I couldn't agree. Time travel is too risky, and we have no guarantee of success. All of Ponyville was at his funeral. However, no one was as heartbroken as Fluttershy. Discord got a stained glass window for his sacrifice, for saving Equestria and us. I, Fluttershy, and our other friends made sure that all of Equestria would hear about his deed. I couldn't watch her misery. I had to do something. I tried to find a spell that could bring him back to life. But from the books, I learned that everyone who tried to do it, even the most powerful wizards, paid a huge price for trying to resurrect their loved ones. All of them died, and none of them ever achieved their goal. But I found something else, something that could work. A spell that summons souls for a short time, and I cast it.
I missed you too. You are so beautiful. I love you, Fluttershy. I'm sorry I didn't tell you this before. I was such a stupid coward.
No, it doesn't matter now. I love you too. You're my hero and I'm proud of you, Dizzy. I don't know if I can do it. Live without you.
I believe in you. You're much stronger than you think.
No, I want to be with you. Please, take me with you.
Fluttershy, I can't. You have friends, family, animals, and your whole life before you.
You also have friends here. I could be your family. If fate gave us a chance, I could marry you and we could have children.
I won't cry. I won't cry.
Discord, thank you for what you did. For saving us.
I'm really sorry.
We miss playing Ogre's and Oubliettes with you.
I'm sorry for how I was treating you.
We all miss you so much.
I'm not mad at you. Rainbow Dash, Rarity, any of you. Say hello to Starlight, Trixie, Tia, Lulu, Sakura, CMCs, Big Mac, and Sugar Bell. Every creature for me.
We will.
Don't worry. One day, we will meet again. Fluttershy, promise me you'll live your life so that you won't regret anything.
I promised. And I'll never love any other stallion.
I have to go in a moment.
Oh.
I can't stay here forever. But I'll leave something for you.
What do you mean?
You'll see. Farewell. See you later, friends. Thank you for everything.
See ya, you big goofball.
We'll miss you.
Take care, Captain Woz.
Fluttershy, don't forget to smile.
Okay.
The time has come, I have to go. But please don't cry, I leave you hope. Because one day, we will meet again.
We won't say goodbye, because this isn't the end. We will meet again in the better place. One day.
Bring my parents for me.
We'll never forget you.
See you soon, my love.
After meeting Discord, Fluttershy felt better. 2 weeks later, she found a broken wagon in the woods, and the little filly. Her parents' bodies lied not far from the wagon. Fluttershy immediately decided to take care of the baby. She decided to raise her as her own. She named her Esper. A few weeks later, strange things began to happen with Fluttershy's body. Her stomach grew bigger. She felt nauseous. It turns out she was pregnant. It was a gift from Discord. It was a miracle. Discord gave her the new life she now bore under her heart. Fluttershy was terrified at first. Then she accepted it and began to enjoy it. I think the heavenly being, the guardian of the afterlife, knew Discord was going to be summoned back to the living world, so Discord got this power from it, just to make Fluttershy live on. The child turned out to be a Draconiquis. Fluttershy named her Melody. Melody and Esper were her most precious treasures. Now Fluttershy had two babies and the animal sanctuary in her hooves, but we all helped her as much as we could. The girls grew healthy. Melody inherited race and magic from her father, but she had her mother's kind heart and personality. When the girls were older, Fluttershy showed them Discord's grave and told them his story. On Melody's 10th birthday, I cast the same spell I used 10 years ago. I gave her a chance to meet her father. Discord accepted Esper as an adopted daughter. The whole family was united for a short while. Melody felt the lack of her father even more after this meeting. But Applejack helped her understand some things and come to terms with reality. And from Starlight, Melody got a late birthday present. A book of memories about her father, our adventures with him since our paths and Discord's paths intertwined for the first time. Years later, the girls grew up and started an independent life, but met regularly with their mother. One by one, My friend started to die of old age, and the time has come for Fluttershy. I had to deal with it, move on, and guard Equestria, on behalf of my friends, on behalf of the Heroes of Harmony. I'm sure wherever Fluttershy's soul went, she found Discord there.
Nothing will ever separate us now.
Are you kidding me? That's a terrible ending. For goodness sake, who killed the main character of the story? How dare you punish my sad, depressed, and heartbroken? You're a heartless creature!
Inky, bye!
What?
Maybe if you stop yelling and complaining, you would see what surprise I prepared for people who are watching us right now.
So, people are watching us? Now?
Yes, a lot of people. So please, can we continue?
Okay, this surprise better be nice.
He doesn't wake up, it's true. But don't let hope leave you.
What? His heart is beating? Sakura, he started to breathe!
Oh, so we did it! That's great! This is the news I've always wanted to hear on this date!
But why doesn't he wake up?
He has a fever, and he doesn't arise. Something is still wrong, even though he is alive. I think his wound may still be infected. I will prepare a mixture to keep him protected.
Infected?
It's not as serious as it sounds. No need to fuss. I can honestly say that the worst is behind us. We have to wait a bit longer. But it seems our troubles are over.
Several days had passed. Fluttershy and Zecora looked after Discord, especially Fluttershy, who never left Zecora's hut. At the request of their friend, Twilight and the rest took care of her pets and animal sanctuary.
Where am I? Bandages? I'm alive. Fluttershy!
Huh? Dizzy!
Yes, it's me.
You finally woke up! Welcome back to the world of the living!
The world of the living? What?
I was so worried about you.
Everything is fine now, I guess. What about Akrios?
You managed to destroy the medallion and Akrios with it. I'm so proud of you. I thought I lost you. But here you are, and I'm very happy about it.
Hello there. You're finally awake. I'm sure your friends will be rid of heartache.
Yo, Sakura! Can you tell me what happened to me?
Well, I'm sure this sounds like something vile. But you can say you were dead for a while.
What? I was dead?
Oh, I'm not surprised at your face. Calm down. You're in a safe place.
I don't want to know how you did it and what you did. This zebra is starting to scare me.
Technically, you weren't completely dead.
This is one and the same.
I think going to sleep now would be the best. At least, I really need some rest.
I think Sakura is right. I feel sleepy and you need some rest. Good night.
Night.
You should be turned into stone with them.
Huh? Someone is having very dark nightmares.
I'm so sorry. Please, you can't die. You can't. Not now. Please, Fluttershy. You are everything to me. Where is she?
If you love her so much, why'd you put her and us in danger? Fluttershy is gone because you decided to free the three villains who killed her. It is your fault! Your fault!
What have I done?
Shh. Calm down, Discord. It's just a nightmare. Fluttershy sleeps peacefully in Zakora's hut, next to you.
Lulu! What are you doing here?
Can you stop calling me Lulu? I sensed that you had nightmares, so I decided to intervene. I may be retired, but I still watch over others' dreams.
I didn't have any nightmares at all.
Sure, you cried for fun. I saw what those dreams were about.
So what?
I want to help you. You and I have more in common than you think. We both made mistakes that we regret, but tormenting yourself about what has been done wrong, punishing yourself, this isn't a good way.
Tell that to the ponies. Every day they remind me of how much they consider me a failure and how much they don't want to have me in their company. At first, I didn't care. I thought that after a few weeks, they would forget. And the weeks turned into months. Everyone has their limits. And I'm just fed up with it.
What about Fluttershy? You love her.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Oh, come on. I heard you say you are everything to me.
Leave me alone. Go away.
But...
Get out!
As you wish, but think about it. You show that you really changed. You sacrificed yourself for your friends. I think it is a good moment to try this one last time. There are creatures in this world who care about you, and who you care about. This isn't worth destroying it. Even when regret and anger overwhelm you, believe me.
Discord! Where are you? Sakura! I'm sorry, I didn't notice you.
No worries, my friend. I'm okay. Your friend is sitting there, surrounded by wood. But it doesn't look like his mood is good.
Hi. How are you? I'm not a doctor, but I don't think you should have gotten out of bed.
Fluttershy, do you remember when I promised you by the river that we'd talk about feelings when it's over?
Yes.
I don't think that you and I... that it will work.
Why?
We are too different. Have you ever wondered about the consequences of a relationship with someone like me? Or maybe you thought everything would be fine. The magic of love will do everything. But no! The magic of love won't do anything. Although at first it may seem different.
What's gotten into you? What's happening? I'm really worried about you.
What did I do to make you fall in love with a monster like me? That I betrayed you? Or maybe because you almost died because of me and my stupid idea?
First of all, you are not a monster. Secondly, that is in the past now. Thirdly, my mother once told me that we don't love someone for anything but who they are. I like the fact that you're funny, creative, intelligent, good, and caring towards me. And you understand me, and accept me as I am. You believe in me. Discord?
It will be best if you forget about me. Find a handsome stallion.
I'm not the right creature for you.
But I don't want some other stallion. I know you better than any pony else. I fell in love with you. And all these adventures we went through together, they mean nothing to you? And the kiss? You returned it. It didn't mean anything to you either?
One kiss on the lips doesn't make two creatures a couple.
If you don't love me, say it to my face. Say it's all just friendship. I don't want to be a puppet in one of your games.
I don't love you. Are you happy?
I thought I meant something to you.
Fluttershy, no. Please wait. Don't act on emotions. You won't think straight. Lord of Chaos! Are happy now? Now you've made her depart? Do you realize how terribly you've hurt her heart? You've hurt she so badly, like you stabbed her with a knife. I've never seen such stupidity in my whole life.
Choose your words carefully, Zebra.
I'm not afraid. You are powerless and weak. And this you need to hear, so I will speak. When she couldn't hear your breathing and heart beating, she hugged your body hard and started weeping. Her sorrow and despair were so overwhelming, and although the hopes faded for you to awaken, she still waited. She didn't want to leave, begged you to wake up. When she doubted and lost hope, I felt like it was breaking my heart. I could not cope. And then you took a breath, and she was so happy and joyful. But your behavior now, it is so awful. You love Fluttershy. Do you think that's fair? You hurt her feelings by denying you care. Not just, I see this emotion in your eyes. I understand why you are as cold as ice. You're afraid to lose her. Is that why you put this act on? You are sure you will not manage when she is gone. But think about it and take my advice. Being together creates a wonderful time. Happy memories will remain even after her lifetime. She will pass away, being satisfied in love. Isn't that worth it? Don't you think that you both deserve it? You will miss her. You will feel despair and emptiness. But memories of Fluttershy will bring you happiness. Awareness that she has spent a good life on you will make the loss less painful. You won't rule. And if you reject her and your feelings for all eternity, you can regret it. Lord of Chaos, is doing that worth it? Don't you think you could at least try? And if not, calmly explain to her why. Go to her, speak truthfully about what you want to say. If you both want to be together, what stands in your way? So what are you standing here? Go and find her. Don't let her disappear.
What if she doesn't want to talk to me? What if it turns out that our personalities are too different? What if I destroy everything again?
I understand that you are afraid. You fight with yourself, unsure of feelings. You are afraid of mortals, life rulings, laws, and dealings. All these big changes. All this love. But I'm fascinated by your friendship, to be honest. You find common ground despite differences large and modest. And although you are so different from each other, you understand, respect, care, and support one another. She loves you, despite all these mistakes, despite pushing them to the brink. She wants to be with you no matter what, don't you think? Listen, quarrels between lovers sometimes occur. The main thing is to not give up, but overcome them together and conquer. Respect is important, but when you are together, as is trust, conversation, understanding, and honesty is also a must. Everything will be fine if you take this to heart, but still, you have to do your part. So why don't you follow her and stay standing here? Perhaps she didn't run far. Perhaps she is near. But this time, you can't make the same mistake. You may never get a second chance and only find heartbreak.
Yes, I hope that she wants to listen to me.
I can't wait to see them.
Girls, they can't see me like this. I don't want to talk to any pony at the moment.
Remember to be nice to him. From what Luna said, his psyche isn't in a very good condition.
Honestly, I'm not surprised about that. If I had to listen to reminders of every mistake I made in my life for so long, you would get my head down too.
Well, let's hope that the surprise Pinky prepares will improve Fluttershy and Discord's mood. They've been through a lot in the last few days.
I wonder if they clarified a certain thing among themselves.
Hi, Sakura! We came to see how Discord and Fluttershy are doing.
I bet they're in your hut.
I'm sorry, but no. They really had to go.
What happened?
Well, there was an unpleasant situation. Suppressed emotions caused by agitation, confessions, harsh words, fight and more. And Fluttershy couldn't take them anymore. So I had to make Discord aware of a few things. I hope he went to talk to her about everything.
So, after all that has happened lately, they're somewhere in the Everfree Forest again? Celestia knows where?
I know that this situation can make you feel fear, but there are times where even friends should not interfere. They must explain everything to each other. No longer can they keep their feelings undercover. Now, they must try their best. And above all, to their feelings, they must put a test.
Fluttershy! Where are you?
You... why did you come here?
I was looking for you.
You are the last person I want to see now. Okay, maybe I did something wrong by the river. I got carried away and surprised you. But nothing justifies your behavior. I want to be alone now. Just go away.
I really like you. We're friends and...
Discord, I don't want to hear about how we can still be friends right now. Leave me alone.
Flutter...
You know that nothing will be the same. I could have thought before I kissed you then. I could have just kept these feelings inside me and not tell anyone about them. I stupidly believed Sakura when she said you loved me. What for Celestia's sake are you doing? Did you want to kiss me? What the hey are you thinking? How dare you play with my feelings like that? I'm not your puppet if you haven't noticed. I don't need your mercy. And forcing yourself to love just because you pity me? Last week was a total emotional roller coaster for me, and you're not helping at all!
Fluttershy, I love you!
What? But earlier, you said... I don't understand anything. I'm confused.
Me neither! I lied because I thought it would be better for both of us. But a certain zebra showed me the truth.
But why did you lie?
I thought before that you would never return my feelings. But when you told me what you were feeling, I was terrified and confused. Also, I was terrified by the prospect of you dying someday, and leaving me alone again. I thought that if I hid my feelings, they would disappear, and what would happen to you would hurt less. I was afraid that I would do something stupid again that would hurt you too. But now I know that you and I, that despite everything, we can be happy. You don't even know how grateful I am for everything you did for me. I'm sorry, and I hope you forgive me someday.
It doesn't change the fact that you hurt me, more than ever before.
I understand. I lost my chance. And I can only blame myself.
Oh, well, I've never really had a friend before.
Well, now you do. He can be a real sweetheart once you get to know him. Now, he's learned his lesson. Isn't that right, my little patient? Can't do that.
And you may not have great physical strength.
Oh, thank you.
Just save Equestria. And keep Fluttershy safe.
I stay here overnight.
I make sure that you don't lose your strength.
Although Fluttershy says me to pray
anyway.
She's my
favorite. I'm very precious. I don't want to. I'm a fool.
What am I doing? I let anger take over me. I still love him. And I lost him once. And now? Discord! Discord waits! I forgive you.
What? Really?
Yes. You came back from the dead. We've got a second chance and I don't want to waste it. I'm so sorry.
No. It must be a dream, but it isn't. Thank you. I love you.
I love you too, Dizzy.
I know I don't deserve you, your kindness and love. Maybe it would be better if I was dead. You would find someone better than me. Some stallion who would treat you like a princess.
Please don't say that. Everyone deserves love. Everyone deserves to live. Everyone makes mistakes, and everyone deserves a new chance. I want you to be happy again. Please, let me take care of your heart. I'll never break it.
I'm so sorry. I really regret every mistake.
Shh. What happened is in the past. Now you have to forgive yourself or remorse will bite you.
I'll try.
Shh. Everything is okay. I know I won't live forever. But I'll do everything I can to make you happy.
Are you sure is this what you really want?
Yes, you silly Draconicles. You don't even know how long and how much I long to hear these words. That you love me.
I love you, Fluttershy. I promise I'll be a good partner for you. I'll never do anything stupid that could hurt you again.
I'm sure you will be.
I still think that we should have stayed in Zecora's hut and waited for them there.
What if something happened to them? It doesn't hurt to check, Applejack.
They aren't kids. They're both adults and know what they're doing.
If they got into trouble again, I'll kill them.
Rarity, are you okay?
They are kissing. Oh, cute. So it looks like they've explained everything to each other.
Finally.
Hello, guys!
Yeah.
Why are you standing like that?
Pinky! Ouch! What's that on my tail?
I hate bushes! Sorry, I didn't mean to scare you.
Are you spying on us?
No, it's not what you think. It's not like we were watching you because we were not watching you. We saw nothing.
We were just worried about you and decided to look for you.
Zecora told us what happened.
And I came to look for all of you. I brought a surprise to Sakura's hut, but none of you were there, and I learned from Sakura what happened, and my pinkies had told me that I would find you, so here I am!
Pinky!
Oops. Probably shouldn't have mentioned the surprise.
What surprise?
Welp, come with us and you will see for yourself.
And by the way, it's great to see you alive. You scared us pretty bad.
You better not try and do it a second time, you big goofball.
This is her way to show that she cares.
Discord, I'm sorry for what I've been saying about you and how I was treating you. I'm really sorry. I know I overreacted.
I'm sorry, too. I should have guessed that you didn't send Timberwolves into Ponyville. I'm sorry I thought so.
You thought I would do that? But why? Oh, I forgot. Because you think I'm a crazy monster! Even if I saved the world 1,000 times, Pony's opinions about me will never change!
Please calm down.
You almost always blamed me first when something bad happened. You don't talk anymore about Luna, Starlight, Trixie, or Tempest past. You forgave them so easily, so many times. But when it comes to me, you don't stop reminding me about what I did wrong. Most of the time when something important happened, you rarely called me, unless you needed my powers. You never invited me to the important events. You ignored me when I really wanted to help. I know I wasn't perfect, and my behavior wasn't the best. And don't lie to me. I know if not this whole thing with... What happened lately? That I almost died? You still would act towards me the way you did before? And yes! I felt left out! I felt unwanted! I felt like a burden to everyone! And there was a time when I didn't want to live!
Discord, I know you feel hurt and unwanted, but what you say is not true. None of us think you're a monster. You're more than a friend to us. You're a part of our family.
Are you saying that honestly?
Yes.
It hurts us to see you in this state.
We are really sorry.
I'm sorry too. I shouldn't have been hiding in the Everfree Forest. I'm sorry for everything.
It's time to leave the past behind. I know that everything will be fine.
Since we've explained everything, can we all go back to Zakora's hut? Someone's waiting for us there.
So be it. Don't let the old zebra worry about us for too long.
We're really sorry you felt that way.
Maybe let's not go back to that anymore.
Most importantly, the worst is over, and each of us learned a lesson.
Yes, that forgiveness is important. That you cannot be angry with others your whole life, that you should tell your loved ones about your problems and feelings, punishing yourself usually doesn't bring anything good, and love is the most powerful magic in the world! Did I forget about something?
I don't think so.
I'm so excited!
Control yourself, Pinky!
Surprise!
Fluttershy! Discord! Good to see you!
I'm so glad you're alive!
Rarity told us what happened! Is it true that you destroyed that big monster with your magic?
Yes.
Awesome.
But I don't understand. What are you all doing here?
This is the surprise!
It was our idea. Mostly Applejack, Spike, and Pinky. We thought that a visit from friends would cheer you up and make you feel better.
You all came for Fluttershy? And me?
Yep.
That's right. You know, I'm really sorry for what I said earlier. That you're selfish and all. Now I see you're just like us.
Huh?
You can care and do your best and so on. I think that's what Sugarbell meant.
Yes, yeah, something like that.
Of course I can. I know I did stupid things. And I made a lot of mistakes in my life. But I'm not the monster you think I am. I want to change. Really.
You've come a long way, Discord. Since your release from Stone, you have learned friendship and other important values. You started as an egotistical and dangerous monster. You have learned what friendship, happiness, care, and dedication are. and also regret the mistakes you've made. A desire to improve. A change for the better for someone.
At our first meeting, we didn't think you were able to be more than just a threat and a selfish clown.
Hey!
And yet, you were ready to give your own life in defense of friends and in defense of Equestria. I believe that there was good in you, that someone special could see and get it out of you. And although sometimes I doubted this decision, now I see that it was right. I am proud of who you are now.
I don't know what.
I never thought that I would say that, but the great and powerful Trixie is impressed by what happened, and she thinks everyone is proud of you.
Well, after all that, it's rather so.
I thank you.
I love happy endings!
I think this is just the beginning. The beginning of something wonderful.
Kiss him!
What? In front of everyone?
Yes! There's nothing to be ashamed of!
Kiss him!
You too?
Is it just me wondering where his fang went?
Thanks, Pinky. Now that won't get out of my mind.
Rarity, I'd advise you start sewing a wedding dress for Fluttershy.
Since the situation is calm, I think we can talk. How are you feeling, Twilight? Are you alright?
There was so much happening lately that I forgot about this. I'm glad that all my friends are safe, happy, and alive again. Alive. Excuse me for a moment.
Where are you going?
Twilight, are you crying?
I decided to visit Ponyville because I wanted to spend some time with you as I used to. There is one thing that has been bothering me for some time. I forgot about it because of the recent crazy events, but now it has come back to me again.
Namely, what?
I don't know how I'd manage without you when you all pass away. I will be a princess of friendship without friends.
Oh, Twilight. We will always be with you.
Even when you can't hear nor see us.
We will be with you in your heart and memories.
Besides, it'll happen in many years. You shouldn't worry about it now.
Pinky is right.
Some things just need to be reconciled and accepted. Otherwise, they'll bring darkness to our hearts.
You have received a wonderful gift from fate.
You will look after Equestria and guard it on behalf of all of us when we leave. On the behalf of the Heroes of Harmony.
I know it will be difficult, but never, ever let fear, sadness, and pain reign over you. And one day, you will find a worthy successor with a pure heart to whom you will pass your heritage, and then you will join those you love.
We believe in you!
And you will be a great ruler.
I love you all so much.
It's getting cold. Don't you want to go inside?
In a few minutes. Now I really feel alive.
Huh? What do you mean?
I existed in this world for quite a long time. But before, nothing mattered to me except sowing chaos. I was blind. My real life started when I made friends. When I met you and the others. When you offered me your friendship. Thank you for everything.
My dear ponies, dear friends, as you can see, this story has a good end. Love does not choose, does not bring strife. It shows love is the way to a healthy life. Even when it seems strange, and you will need a little change. When we think we will not overcome adversities, in love, joint efforts strengthen the feeling and push through all difficulties. The most important thing is to listen to your heart's voice. When it comes to making a difficult choice, don't be afraid of feelings. Don't run away. They will always show you the right way. Everyone wants to be loved and to love. And remember, friendship is magic and power is love.
After this adventure, peace reigned in Equestria for a long time. Creatures of all sorts lived side by side in accordance and harmony. A golden era in the history of the Land of Ponies, and all thanks to Princess Twilight Sparkle and her amazing friends. But you definitely want to know what happened next with Discord and Fluttershy, right? That's why you're still here. And after all, this story was about them. 3 months later, Discord completely licked his wounds. He regained his powers and full strength, and his former joy in life. We've also prepared a surprise for him. That was our thanks for risking his life to save us and Equestria. A stained glass window depicting the victory of Discord over Acrius. On the unveiling of the stained glass window, there was only us, the Elements of Harmony, and a few of our closest friends. Discord also prepared a surprise for Fluttershy and proposed to her. Of course, she agreed. Later, Spike told me that Discord overheard one of the conversations about the surprise and tried to get more information from Spike and Big Mac. They told him that Fluttershy wanted to propose to him, which wasn't true, and Discord tried to propose to her first. Of course, later it all came out, but luckily no one was angry with anyone. Soon after, Fluttershy and Discord got married and lived together in his dimension. Discord was still reluctant to think that one day Fluttershy would die. The thought of external life without her terrified him more than the prospect of death. So he decided to give up his immortality. He asked me for help in this. I found a spell that deprives someone of immortality and cast it on him. The Lord of Chaos has finally found his place in the world and true happiness. He also kept his word to Fluttershy and me, and never put Equestria in danger again. A few years later, they adopted a several-month-old unicorn, abandoned in the forest. They gave her the name Esper, which means hope. 3 years later, an unexpected miracle happened. Fluttershy became pregnant and gave birth to a small, charming pony and Jaconiquus hybrid. They called her Melody. Discord and Fluttershy also had a son, Rising Star. They were an unusual but happy and loving family. Years went by. Old generations gave way to new ones. The circle of life continued uninterrupted. Inexorable time left its mark on Discord and Fluttershy. Their children grew up and started living on their own. In old age, the couple lived in Fluttershy's former home. There, Fluttershy gave her last breath. She died as the last of my close friends. But she left happy in the presence of a loving family. Discord's heart broke then. He followed in the footsteps of his wife that night. When Discord died, a small part of his soul entered his daughters and son, strengthening their magical powers and giving them a long life. Who would have thought that the fate of these two would be this way? Nobody expected it, even they, from enemies to friends to lovers. But their story is a great example of how a small spark of kindness can change someone's life. How one person can change someone's life for the better. Never before I've seen such a powerful love as the one shared by these two, and never after. Do I miss my friends? Of course, but as long as I remember them, they will be with me. I tell the next generations about their story. I teach my students and young foals about what the Elements of Harmony represented. Kindness, honesty, laughter, loyalty, generosity, and magic are in each of us. And thanks to what we have the best in us, we can change the world and creatures around us for the better. Not through epic battles and great deeds, but through small gestures of everyday life. And although my first and best friends are gone, I will never close my heart to others and to new friendships. Here I am, Twilight Sparkle, Princess of Friendship, ruler, protector, and guardian of Equestria, a member of the Heroes of Harmony.
Thank you, friends. Thank you for everything.
Time of love and hatred, when the whole world is against me, for mistakes I know I'm guilty of, for the chaos that would blind me, how I miss the times before the world changed. Not a thing I did was harm to you, but you were kind to me, and you reminded me I'm not as evil as I knew I was. I'm not the beast I used to be, because you showed me how to be a friend. Though I know my actions you can't defend, but you stayed, and you called my name. When others would have walked out as they continue to blame, but you have stayed with me, despite my destiny. We walk across the flowered hillside, and all the insults we just push aside. Just like cocoons that become butterflies, the beauty grows though it can try to hide. But you pull me through in the dark night. Would those butterflies turn out to be that unusual pair of my caring mare? If I had to do this all a second time, I've learned the darkness is not all I can see.